Hello, I'm Pastor Andrew Draper from Urban Light Community Church, and we are now looking at week number 3, the homework for the Impact Discipleship Method. We are in the Transforming Life workbook by Dr. Kwesi Kamau from Impact Church in Dallas, Texas, and we are working through the homework now for week 3. We're recording it on a video so that there is auditory record of the homework, so that if you want to engage through it in a way other than reading and writing or visually, you can hear it. So we want it to be available and accessible for all people. So here we are in the homework for group week number 3. And again, if you'll remember, the assignment for each week includes memorizing 2 scriptures. For days 1 and 2, we work on the first scripture. Days 3 and 4, we work on the second scripture. And day 5 is a lesson. In addition, this week, we're asking you to practice the PRAY method. It's an acronym, P-R-A-Y. And I'm going to read through very quickly for you here what that is. One of the main words for prayer in the Old Testament is tefillah. This prayer is not merely asking for something. It is more personal fellowship with God, where you come together with God and reflect on your heart and your life. It is a time to examine one's life in the light of the beauty of God's holiness and to focus your heart on God. You can use the PRAY method, P-R-A-Y, as a guide to tefillah prayer. Now remember, tefillah means an intimate union with God, beyond just the head into the heart. Beyond just telling God what we need or speaking a bunch of stuff to him, but being content sitting in his presence. So practicing this method 30 minutes each day for a week is a good way to learn how to pray. The PRAY method. P, praise. Count your blessings and recall how God provided each one. Thank God for each one and praise God for how God did what God did. You can read Psalm 103, verse 2, if you want to know more about that. But first, count your blessings and praise God. Second, reflect. Reflect means read the Bible and use God's word to reflect on your heart and your life. Repent of any sins that come to mind. This would be Hebrews chapter 4, verse 12. So first, P, we praise. Second, we reflect on what we've read in the Bible. Number 3, adore. Ask God to connect with your mind and heart. Ask the Holy Spirit to pour out God's love into your heart in a real and meaningful way. Read Romans chapter 5, verse 5. This is moving beyond simply reflecting on God's word to the adoration of the love of God, adoring God. Number 4, yield. This is that tefillah prayer, that intimate union with God, where we yield, we lift up every issue we're facing, good and bad, to God. We surrender every worry and every concern. You can read Psalm 46, verse 10 about this, where, you know, it says, be still and know that I am God. So this PRAY method is a good way to learn how to pray. That's a good, easy way to remember it. Praise, reflect, adore, and yield. All right, now let's move to the daily homework. Day number 1, this day we are working on memorizing John chapter 8, verses 31 through 32. So let's pull that up here. John chapter 8, verses 31 through 32. And again, I'm using the Bible Gateway app, which is free. On your phone or on your computer, BibleGateway.com, and we're reading from the NIV, the New International Version. But you can also listen to it on the app or the website in the audio Bible section. And the verse reads, to the Jews who had believed him, Jesus said, if you hold to my teaching, you are really my disciples. Then you will know the truth. And the truth will set you free. Again, you can take that in separate phrases, work on repeating it over and over. Our homework for the first day is to write it out word for word. And again, if you don't write, you can type, you can speak aloud, you can do whatever you need to do to repeat it over and over and over to memorize that verse. If you want to pause there and do that now, you can. And then here is our daily activity to consider. Consider the following. Keeping Christ's teaching leads to meaningful experience with God. 2 Peter chapter 1, verses 3 through 4 says, His divine power has given us everything we need for a godly life through our knowledge of Him who called us by His own glory and goodness. Through these, He has given us His very great and precious promises, so that through them you may participate in the divine nature, having escaped the corruption in the world caused by evil desires. If you want to pause there and consider that, you can. And then also we're reminding you to practice the pray method for 30 minutes every day. Pray. This is the spiritual discipline component. Praise, reflect, adore, yield. So remember, this discipleship curriculum is teaching us to memorize scripture and to practice spiritual disciplines. That's the homework for day one. All right, day number two. Here's your homework for week number three, day number two. On this day, we're writing out John chapter 8, verse 31 through 32 in your own words. Or speaking it in our own words, or typing it, or reflecting on it in our own words to make sure we understand it. Then here are the questions to answer. Number one, freedom requires that we not simply believe in Jesus, but that we follow His teachings. So list five specific teachings of Christ about various subjects. It's number one. You can go to places like the Sermon on the Mount, Matthew chapter 5 through 7. You can go to parables like Matthew 13. You can look at any of the Gospels. John has a ton of teaching of Jesus, especially in chapters, right around chapters 13 during the upper room, and then 14 through 17 would be just very dense teaching of Jesus, you know, ending in his high priestly prayer in John 17 and so on. So you can look different places for those. Number two, sometimes we need to understand something to do it. Other times we need to do something to understand it. Does that make sense? It's not just that we need to get it first in order to do it. Sometimes we need to do it in order to get it. It works both ways. So the question is, how do you think each one of these statements is true? Reflect on that in your own life. And then we're asking you to practice the pray method for 30 minutes each day. Praise, reflect, adore, and yield. Now on to day three. This is your homework for week three, day number three. We are working on writing out, we're reciting and memorizing Galatians 5:1. It's Galatians chapter 5, verse 1. And the Word of God reads, It is for freedom that Christ has set us free. Stand firm then, and do not let yourselves be burdened again by a yoke of slavery. It is for freedom that Christ has set us free. Stand firm then, and do not let yourselves be burdened again by a yoke of slavery. You can pause there if you want to. Split it into phrases, to write it out, to work on memorizing it, to speak it out loud. And then consider the following. Number one, the freedom for which we are made free is for us to fulfill God's purpose for humankind. Genesis chapter 1, verses 27 through 28 reads, So God created mankind, just means humanity, in his own image. In the image of God, he created them. male and female, he created them. God blessed them and said to them, be fruitful and increase in number. Fill the earth and subdue it. Rule over the fish in the sea and the birds in the sky and over every living creature that moves on the ground. Number two, freedom requires for us to stand firm against Satan's lies and traps. Ephesians chapter 6, verse 11 reads, put on the full armor of God so that you can take your stand against the devil's schemes. Do you want to pause it and reflect on those? Journal, talk to God about it, and then we're reminding you to practice the pray method for 30 minutes each day. And now on to day number 4 of your homework for week 3. Now you're writing out Galatians chapter 5, verse 1 in your own words. I read it for you for day 3. You can also look it up on the Bible Gateway app. You can listen to it. And then answer the following questions. Christ set you free on the cross. How did what Jesus did on the cross set you free? Again, Christ set you free on the cross. So the question is, how did what Jesus did on the cross set you free? Think about that. Reflect on it. You can pause after any of these questions to do so. Number 2, everyone has developed flesh patterns, ways to handle or cope with situations in the absence of God's grace. So the question is, in what ways is the Holy Spirit challenging you to change your thinking or your behavior? Number 3, like Adam and Eve, Satan's lies are meant for you to forfeit your freedom. So the question is, how do you think spending time in God's Word can help you overcome Satan's lies? You can take time and reflect on any of those, journal on them, pray about them. Now we're reminding you to practice the pray method for 30 minutes each day. Praise, reflect on God's Word, adore the Lord, and yield to the presence of God. And now day 5 for week number 3. Our lesson today is faith in God. Faith in God is the second foundational principle for disciples found in Hebrews 6, 1 through 2. When you turn from dead works, you turn to follow God's leading through God's Word and Spirit-filled prayer. Now, you've been practicing Spirit-filled prayer this week using the pray method. Now, if you remember, every 2 weeks is a new foundational principle for discipleship from Hebrews 6. And faith in God is the second foundational principle. Now, you've been practicing Spirit-filled prayer this week using the pray method. So we want you now to take some time and reflect on that. Your homework says, here it gives you space in your book. It says, write down how the pray method has helped you this week. How did God lead or strengthen you this week? And be prepared to share this during the next sessions, group exercises. So our group exercise for week 4 will be sharing with one another how the pray method changed the way we pray, or how God led us or strengthened us throughout the week. Again, if you don't write, you can speak out loud, you can pray, you can reflect, you can type if you type. But reflect on how the pray method has helped you this week. And that is the end of week 3's homework. We look forward to seeing you at week 4's session. And the next video will be me recording your daily homework for week 4. God bless.